Lots on the line here. Don't want to end up in the loser bracket. And Big will be starting off on the CT side with Monte on the team.
I love this as well, the double boost.
Oh.
Really, really fast control here towards the apartment. Sometimes this angle is amazing. How on earth does he read that? That is fantastic. Man advantage going Monty's way, and what a start.
I would have really liked to see the two-man commitment there, Josh. But Hype, he knows for a fact that he wants to reel it back in terms of the numbers, right? Wants to play very close. Sees the first head. There it is. Nice and clean. Headshot, but he immediately receives a response in the form of some die young. 3-on-4, and most of the action's just been happening here in apartments, man. Where's the rest of the map?
Yeah, what a bizarre start to the round, right? As you say, the double boost and then only a single commitment from tabseN. Really crisp shot from Hype to trade it, but some die young just flexing his muscles, showing off. Really clean taps and Big. Oh my goodness, they made a complete over rotation. They're expecting this to be a late B hit. That's not the case at all. They've read it all wrong. Monte are going to walk into an empty A bomb site. They're going to be scratching their heads, going, where's everybody gone? No one's home. And with 30 seconds left, this C4 will go down and Big have got to pull off a retake. A kit on Keto, though.
No
so
way.
A slightly longer fuse on the round, perhaps.
Oh, man. I didn't agree with Boris pushing in there, but if he can get a kill like that, who's going to complain? 2-on-4, Krimbo and Keto. Have to go for the retake of their lives right now, but they're definitely no chance. Boros in a great position as well. That is Monty with the first round.
Yeah, I mean, you kind of look at those gunfights, like Boros getting aggressive there. You think, okay, there's no major need for that. You've got a man advantage. You've got the site. Take those post plants. I like the aggression into jungle, but actually peeking and pushing the murder hole, it has a bit of a reputation, right? It gets its name from somewhere. And yeah, playing a dangerous game, but confidence. Confidence is very, very important. And going into the first round in a match like this, Boros having the confidence to take those gunfights and actually that confidence being brought on the fact that he's winning them as well. Absolutely fantastic for him. USP's trying to overwhelm. They do a lot of damage. Need to be careful. MQ. Oh, he's farming him. Oh, it's a firing range. Almost an ace. A 4K from MQ. Of course, it's just eco frags, but feel good frags, I like
just
to say.
Just eco frags? They're called the HLTV patterns.
Oh, yeah. The HLTV pattern. Look at that. 176 ADR. What a demon. Mm-hmm. Just keep that up.
But yeah, I still like, I mean, this might just look like a throwaway round, right? But the fact that MQ steps in at the right time and stops them from losing two rifles is actually very important heading into the rest of the game. But now Big have brought out the weapons. 3 players on A, 2 players on B. Not really too much of an early contest on either side of the map, with the exception of one of these players poking their head. Boros does want to get a little cheeky here around ramp. 2 of the T players already starting to take a bit of control towards underpass. Favin has given up his position along with a teammate in an effort to go for a double nade, but it simply doesn't pan out.
Presence in ramp. Keto. Underneath the balcony as well. Molly's to come his way, but actually, don't flush him. I'm playing around the smokes here and all this noise as well. Demq above him. Firepower definitely in Big's favor, but at the cost of the utility. 2 smokes and a flashbang left for the minute on this clock. And look how much Monty have still got to execute with.
Be very careful. Boros, how do you turn around like that and still get the kill? TabseN, in an effort to kill the player in Palace, doesn't pay attention to the player in Connector. Now it's a 3 war on 2K. This is where the murder hole's name comes from. Josh, Hype, crucial shot to be missing. And Favin might just have to pick up the pieces here. Monty still have yet to get the bomb down. Hamdayang to go Big, nearly gets the kill on Connector, but no cigar. Great round by Big.
Yeah, they bite back and they bite back quite nicely. Monty, of course, a bit of a bonus in that last round, so they can reinvest comfortably. The AKs come out. Remember, they still have those Galils on the majority of them, but no AWP available. Warro maybe doesn't need it just yet, but with Hyped having one in hand, it's definitely a factor that comes into it. You want an AWP to be able to contest that mid-control, to be able to take those early fights. Don't really want to be swinging into him with an AK. Interesting smokes. Oh, what is that from tabseN? That's awkward. Takes a whole load of damage, and now he's a little bit stuck.
Oh man, this is getting really messy here in middle, Josh. A 4-on-3. And the question is, how do Big restructure their pieces to take this into account? Bomb starting to go back. Wants to reroute its efforts towards B apartment. Players are gonna join from underpass as well, but the rotations are a good effort here from Big because tabseN has joined the fray as well. Shouldn't be too long before Keto starts to chime into the party as well, but they've given up a lot of information already. Primbo now has to back off, and this is gonna be a doozy. Smoke deployed already, preemptively to avoid that Molotov from being a problem. Jumping up to deploy that has a one-way smoke as well. You can see that Monte are feeling a little antsy about actually pushing this. Time to head to A, and seems like Big aren't going to be ready for this.
tabseN. Oh, no. His crosshair was ready. He was ready for those fights, and he was probably going to win them, but didn't expect Warro coming in from behind. Interesting that he didn't hear the jump, actually. There's no way Warro can get up there by himself without making noise. It's going to be a hard save call. Krimbo and Keto recognize the value of the rifles they have, but maybe not enough because, well, a clean headshot will take out Krimbo. Keto's now going to hold on to this AK-47, a luxury that he cannot buy on the CT side. So if he can hold on to it, it's definitely worth its weight in gold. His teammates don't really have enough to invest around him in the next, but considering he's on that CT side, he's still getting his loss bonus anyway. It's worth having a bit of firepower, but no way does he get away with it when Warro's creeping around, slithering, silent. An assassin that comes in from behind and pounces. 3-1, Monte get off to a really good start here on their pick of Mirage.
Yeah, definitely no complaints at all. I mean, they allow Vic to get away with one round, but then immediately after, they're able to batter the economy. I think they're going to be pretty happy with that circumstance. Just pistols. Desert Eagle in the hands of tabseN, a P250 for Hyped, 5.7 for Keto. Everybody else are probably just two players remaining on USPs. Shouldn't be too difficult for Monte to lap up these rounds. And I think that CT side might be proving a little difficult already for Big if they can allow Monte to get away with so many opening rounds.
Oh.
Can't even see him. It's too quick.
Yeah. Keto can't get anything done. Oh, man. I think it's a little bit worrying here as well that Keto and tabseN haven't put a kill on the board yet. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean, like, it's not the be-all end-all, right? We're already going into round number six. But in terms of confidence, and I think you would understand this as somebody that has played competitive CS as well. I'm somebody, especially, that really, I get in my own head a little bit when I get off to a slow start. And if you go into sort of round six, round seven, you have a couple of buy rounds, you have no success, and you've, yeah, you round into to number seven or eight with no kills. That's it. That's me mentally checked out. I really struggled to sort of get back into the game after that. These guys are a whole lot more mentally resilient than I am, but it's still a little concerning. Two of the harder hitters for this squad as well. tabseN creeping round.
Sundayang is in such a crucial position here, Josh. He knows that somebody just stepped in the connector, but he needs to check for tabseN.
Oh, wow.
One for one trade. tabseN's happy. He's just been able to get on the board, right? No, apparently that was an assist as well, so sorry, tabseN, you might just be James Bond in the next round. But it's time for the 4-on-4 retake. I'm not sure if they're actually going for it, though, Josh, because they do have a singular kit.
Oh, wow. This is the issue as well. Their buy rounds. This has happened in both buy rounds now, too. They've massively, massively prioritized the firepower over the utility and the kit. Their first buy round, they were in a position where, they just had no util left. For the minute on the clock, I pointed it out, there were two smokes and a flashbang, whilst Monte still had full belts on three players to go for a full execution. And it just made things impossible. It made things absolutely impossible for Big. And right here, yeah, the same applies. A 4v4 retake that you would absolutely go for ordinarily if you had a bit of utility to work with and you had a kit or two in the arsenal. But they don't. So they say, you know what, the bomb's already halfway ticked. By the time we get there, there's absolutely no chance. So yeah, maybe time in situations like that to drop down to a FAMAS, make sure you've got a little bit of extra utility, make sure there's a kit on somebody. They won't make that same mistake again. There's two, Faven and tabseN with them. Yeah, 006. Rough start for tabseN. Last round, Sumdae Young trading one for one. Mac-10 with an M4 as well. Shouldn't be happening. And round number seven, Monte. Do they really pull away further here?
Yeah, you can see that they've quickly now started to take into account the fact that they need to buy kits. And I'm kind of liking the bit of aggression that's coming out from Big as well. They're willing to play a little closer to ramp, try and get the numbers advantage early on instead of just letting Monte play to their own pace. The problem is, most of the attention from the T side will be heading towards B and middle. There is one player tucked into Palace, but it's going to be a little while before that starts to become a point of contention. That Palace player is going to be so important for that late connector and mid presence.
Absolutely good beat. TabseN, oh, spamming through the smoke. Painfully close to connecting, but no one on the receiving end of it. Takes a bit of damage from that Molly as well as he falls back. Crimbo eats a nade. A very slow start. Look at the time here. Oh, this could be big. He's got the bomb as well.
Oh man, Keto and Hyper in such difficult positions, but Hyped and Faven, they've gotten a kill apiece. And as they start to pour out of Palace, tabseN will be quick on the trigger. Waro knows that he's a little bit checked out, unless Sumdae Young can say about it, and Hype is already on his case, so Waro has to bow out of this one, Josh. Big, about as clean of a round as it can be, but it couldn't have come soon enough, because right now, Monty are on about that $8,000, $9,000 mark, so actually fighting back against him will be incredibly difficult, to say the least.
Yeah, you could say that. Big round from Big. Feels so weird saying that, right? Mm-hmm. Feels like I'm always trying to make these puns, but I'm not. It's not intentional.
Yeah,
it's just
the,
an important round
the one time you don't want to make puns, and you get a team that has like one of the most common words in the English language. Like that's how you describe anything that is big or significant.
And I'm somebody that uses it too much as well already. Oh, man. But enough money in the bank here for Monte to go for a proper buy. They will actually have a little bit of reserve cash as well as a cushion that they can fall back on if needs be. So round number eight, not as important for them, but they definitely want to bite back after an awkward round lost like the last. Good nade. Waro tag right down low. Smoke lands right in front of him as well. Cuts him out of the equation a little. Hyped over the top of this smoke. Doesn't quite act as a one way, but he's got tabseN to support. Sumdae Young's holding it. Timing's everything here.
Oh man, I really like that awareness from tabseN. The fact that he doesn't over aggress at all, he knows that they haven't peeked their heads anywhere on the map. So there's a good chance they might just be playing a very strong default while they're relying on the players from mid to be relevant late into the round. So now tabseN will finally get a piece of the action. There are two players set up though for the fight. And with this AWP staring down middle, actually getting past tabseN is going to be very difficult. But B site is what is really up in contention. Boros, he's in. There it is, though, from Crimbo. He's been able to get two frags. And while B site might have been looking like it was up for grabs, not while it is on Crimbo's watch. Start to pour out. One player drops down. Keto's watching the cross. Molotov doesn't actually catch Crimbo because it's towards the right. And Hyped, in the meantime, has already made himself relevant. And I love the spacing from Crimbo. Doesn't need to peek out at all. Has full faith that his teammates are going to chime in. But when he doesn't, Waro will be able to capitalize. Time to move into the site because you've only got 15 seconds. Waro trying to wrap around the pillar. Knows there's a player in the smoke. Tries to go for the knife. Falls. And there it is. The round from Big. Disastrous, but it still goes their way.
Oh, okay. A little close for comfort, but yeah, Big take it. Secondary AWP comes out too, and they've got a couple of very capable snipers here on the roster, so no major surprise there. An important time for it. Gap being closed. Monty's momentum doesn't get to carry through. I think that's a really important factor. It's not that they're completely a momentum-based squad.
Oh?
You take away the push. Ooh.
Yeah, a little uncomfortable there for... I believe it was Hype to peek into a connector.
Yeah, that's awkward. Yeah, especially with Sun Dae-young, is just kind of not even bunny hopping, just jumping across. Like, ouch. Oh, it's so dangerous. What a shot. Decapitated. See ya, hyped. Is Warrior going to expect another AWP, though?
Knows that aggression grab is about to come through, and he does manage to find the kill, but soon after, DemQ is going to start having a conversation too. TabseN in the meantime rotates in from Connector, knows they're about to pour out of Palace, and he's preemptively ready for it. Gets a kill without really having too much to pay for had he not backed into the Molly. But now it's time for Big to start bringing their pieces together before they actually go for the retake. A little bit of a time investment will be had, but there it is, Waro. Wants to preemptively go for that frag. Is able to find one around the smoke. And Crimbo, he's a little late to the party, but I think his positioning might be difficult for them to predict. Waro, watching the smoke, though, isn't going to be surprised by it at all. And Favin, there is nothing you can do when Crossnell's watching that angle like a hawk. Big, they falter once again.
Well, Monty, perhaps back to winning ways. I'm really not too sure how repeatable some of these rounds really are, but they've done a good job at just getting that early mid control. I think Sun Dae-young's playing an amazing role. It's interesting to see how he kind of falls into this roster. I think his play style actually really, really tailors towards being in a squad like this, where he's not as confined as he was in Na'Vi. He can kind of be the star. He can be the one that goes and looks for those openings. Not cast in the shadow of Simple any longer. Pushing underpass. I mean, another buy here for Big, but not without its contingencies. A FAMAS on Crimbo, tabseN with an MP9. Not a lot of util either. Nothing of an offensive nature except for that one HE. It's flashbangs and smokes, so you can put up walls, but you can't keep them back. Boros. As soon as this smoke fades, he surely wins this fight. This is so sneaky. Oh, no, not like this. Oh, ho, ho, ho.
So much space already being gained. Hyped. Very important for him to get that frag there. At least try and bring the numbers back closer, because keep in mind, they're constantly staring down the barrel of economic defeat. Gotta be incredibly careful here. Lots of space for it to be made, but DemQ, or rather Crimbo, will be able to pick up two very important pieces, and where Monte could have had the advantage, they're starting to lose out on it. Bomb is out in no man's land as well, Krosnell. And Waro, now they're going to have to try and jump the gun. Very difficult to get past Crimbo, even if all he's got is a measly FAMAS, Josh. And Waro already knows. He just has to stick to this AWP with dear life.
Well, I guess so. I wouldn't be opposed to seeing a crazy, crazy clutch. But, of course, he knows that that was out of the question. Had to just hold on to it. Wasn't a lot of time left on that ticker either. So, yeah, carries that one into the next. And an interesting economic situation that they're in, right? Lucky for him, he did have a bit of cash in the bank. For his teammates, they didn't have that same luxury. So actually, him not getting a loss bonus isn't the end of the world. He can keep 3,000. Everybody else, yeah, a couple of pistols, but no one investing too heavily below the 2K mark. They'll have a buy up in the next. But it does mean that this AWP is unsupported in this round. It either goes absolutely huge or it becomes a little redundant. Maybe you play past the parcel with it for now. A fast play out into the A site and, well, a crunch.
Man, it's so weird to think that the previous round, where Monty pretty much looked like they had all of the pieces working in their favor, Big's economy could have been entirely broken down. They could have been in the position where Monty get away with perhaps even 8 rounds without too much of a contest, but with some of these individuals shining, like Crimbo just being an absolute madman with the FAMAS, now we're seeing a completely different horizon at the very least. At least Monty are going to get a chance to get back to their high horse with their weapons at least. First tactical timeout is being brought underway. And by the way, guys, sorry for the little error on the stream earlier. I was just trying to figure out the titles and all. Just had a little, we just had a few bugs on our end, so now it should be displaying exactly what the match is and all that good stuff.
Good. Happy days. Mm-hmm. Little tactical timeout.
He was showing like team ATK or something earlier. Just have to fix that up.
Right. Well, you can't call yourself a Counter-Strike fan if you don't know who these guys are, right? Sometimes we cast some really obscure games. Sometimes we're doing some real tier 20, not sure who some of these players are. So that's fair enough. You get the names wrong, people aren't sure who you're watching. But if you don't know these names, you don't know who these guys are, you're not a Counter-Strike fan, right? So it's okay. I don't think it's had... Yeah, I don't think anyone's too upset, too confused. Round number 12, though. Monte, of course, calling a timeout in that little pause there. Just, I mean, I can't even imagine what they've been discussing, right? But with the economy in tatters as it is, three Galils, two AKs. Now, remember, they did have about 2K in the bank last round, but the loss bonus just hasn't been there. So they might lose this lead. Things could tie up, and off the back of it, Big could likely push themselves into a strong half. Good starts. Oh, my goodness, Keto. Oh, ho, ho.
Waro. I don't think he felt like he had much of a chance there after that 3K from Keto, but now one on two. He's at least brought it to a position where it is salvageable. Frimbo has a whole lot of HP, but Favin is simply not in the same shoes. I think he might want to double back and go back to A. Doesn't want to go the long way around and go to B instead.
This is still doable. These two players completely split up as well. 2 1-for-1 fights. Of course, it's Crimbo that he'll be facing up against first. He's got to take down the full HP man. But if he can get it done, then a much easier job in the second. That support flash is amazing. Favon with 10 HP. Knows he can't have much impact with the bullets. So needs to bail his teammate out. And he does. That's just so, so well played.
Man, so many of these rounds from Big have come off the back of one of their players just going absolutely wild, right? In the previous round, it was Keto. A couple rounds before that, it was Crimbo. We've seen tabseN get a couple of nice frags as well. I'm not really seeing too much of the team element from Big right now, but I am really liking their individual performance. Monte, of course, now on just the pistols. A chance for Big to cool down. Chance for Monte to hypothesize where they want to go in the rest of the game, what they want to do.
And this is going to be a little bit of a confidence booster for Big. I think the last couple of rounds going very, very well for them. Remember, the first few that they were able to put on the board were quite scrappy. It felt very lackluster. And rounds like that don't fill you with confidence. They almost fill you with a bit of relief. Like, oh, just about managed to get that one over the edge. Now they're actually having some rounds where it feels like they've got a bit of cohesion and things are coming together. Yeah, I think that's going to fill them with a lot of confidence, but especially considering this is their opponent's map pick. Hyped having a great game so far. He's filling the boots very nicely. And once again on this AWP, playing a dangerous game around these smokes. Timing's important. Narrowly whiffs onto DemQ. Knows that he can't double dip. Look how much space he's got. That's ridiculous. Timing impeccable.
Oh, yeah. And that is all the space they were looking for. Now, Big have to play this a little bit more passively. Two players in connector, one of them rotating back towards B, actually. And in his attempt to do just that, DemQ's already going to be on his case. Because in the chaos, Crimbo didn't realize that somebody had already made it into ladder room. I think Crimbo might be trying to sell the idea that they only have one, or rather, the B player has started to rotate. That's why he threw the smoke late on. He's going to have a very difficult fight to get past if he wants to make this war. There it is. First headshot. Nearly gets the bomb planter as well, but Boros will respond. Tabson now has to hold on to this B site with his dear life, unless they decide to go A, which they do have plenty of time for.
Perfect shot from tabseN. Oh, misses the second, though. You don't want to be giving Boros an opportunity. That's exactly what he does. Gets out onto the site, gets that bomb down, but knows, yeah, he knows he needs to take that fight with tabseN before Faven arrives at the party. And there's not a whole lot more you can do than swing into the Orphra and hope you hit the head and hit it quickly. To be honest, if there's any player I'd expect to do it, it would be Boros. But unfortunately, his luck's dried up. He falls short there. And Big make it, they win the half at the very least. But now we see to what extent. Can they make it 9? Can they extend this gap a little? I think based on how they've played in the last few rounds, I guess they deserve it. Double up setup in play once again. Monte with no sniper available. But an SG on Krasnil. Interesting. He's had a really slow map so far.
We don't even get a chance to make that SU work. Some die young, looking absolutely incredible with the same A, along with Demkyu, who's been able to open up the A site. Boros joins him in this effort as well, and Keto will have to go absolutely big if he wants to stop this A site offense. Do they even know there could potentially be someone in Palace? There he is, he steps out, player in Sandman is gone, wants to peek out for further kills, and he's able to get a double, but he eventually gets tucked into his grave, and now Krimbo's on for the 1v2. His position's been spotted over towards apartments, and now he has to go for the big rotate. Bomb, nearly over towards A. At least he has a little bit of buffer time before he actually has to go for this retake, so the bomb hasn't been thrown down just yet. Preemptive Molotov to stop him from getting into a good position. Flashbang to cross for SDY. And they might just know where Krimbo is with that peek from Woro. Nade at the ready. A little bit of damage brings him within one headshot territory. It all just comes down to the aim now and how he micromanages these angles. Wants to make his way towards CT. Has an inkling of an idea that SDY might be there. But he's wasted quite a bit of time. Krimbo going for the long wrap around. We can get a CT first, but Some Die Young is ready. And that's going to be it for the first half. Monte, incredible work. But at the very least, Big have been able to get back on their feet and make it a decent half. Stay tuned. We'll be right back after a very short break.
there from Big, despite what Monte was able to cook up on T side, but now it's their chance to do the same back. Now, Monte, you have the same side advantage.
Glock's in play. tabseN with a molly and a smoke. For everybody else, it's Kevlar. Well, in fact, I say that, right? He's got Kevlar. He's kind of tanked up a little bit with that U2. It's been dropped over. Keto with a P250. And they're just going to try and fly into this A bomb site and take all the jewels. Monty playing a retake setup, so they'll let him have it. That's going to allow a bomb plant at the very least. And a tricky retake to get done, especially without a kit.
Yeah, they've got all five players alive. How has Hype managed to get away with two? I think the CTs are feeling a little locked out right now. Krosnull is able to get Favn, though they're getting a little too over-aggressive, and Monty has suddenly come out with the advantage. There's no way they should be able to get this round, but Keto now in a one-on-three. All he's got to hold on to is a C250. First throw taken away. That could be the second headshot as well, but DemQ denies.
Oh, a big recovery from Monty. I was actually really concerned there, to be honest. Playing a hard retake setup on the A site with no kits on pistol round is a very, very dangerous game. It means that you have to quickly get those kills in. When that double came through as well towards jungle, I thought, right, this is over. They've made the wrong call here, but no. Absolutely brilliant conversions. They swing it their way, and going into the 17th, things are tied up. But playing this retake setup on the A site, allowing them the bomb plant, does also allow them a bit of money here. So we will see somewhat of a buy going into this this second round. Warro with an AWP, which is a little bit crazy. Let's see what he can do with it. Don't want to get overwhelmed by Tech Nines or a Mac 10.
Oh man, this is going to be very difficult for Demi to hold on. He's given up his position. Tech Nine to take his head off, and the CTs are a little locked up before they actually get a chance to make themselves relevant.
Wow.
It doesn't matter. Robin's gotten so far, and he's the AWP as well. Sum Dayoung and Boros are going to have to go big, but they're starting to fall one by one. Sum Dayoung's a little on HP, and he falls. Beautiful work done by Big, and to think it came off the back of pistols.
Yeah, that is ridiculous. I said that AWP does not want to get overwhelmed by Tech-9s. It probably wasn't really the right time to pull something like that out. Now, Warro, he had a good position for it, right? Don't get me wrong. He was in a good spot to say, yeah, you know what? I'm going to buy myself an AWP. But that exact thing happens. He gets overwhelmed by Faven's Tech-9. Remember, Faven's the secondary AWPer as well. So once he picks up that sniper, he is deadly with it. And the secondary shot that he hits, the flick into the CT spot, is just unbelievable. That seals the deal. Final nail in the coffin.
Sorry, I'm just gonna have to take a quick look at what's going on with the audio.
Oh, I see it. People saying PGL audio.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah. Just trying to figure that out. I'm not sure if it's going to happen anymore. I've tried to fix it on my end, but let's see.
Okay. We can hope. Force by here from Monty. Of course, they're on double eco, so they kind of had to bring something into this, I guess, but it's nothing too substantial. Big opening from Keto. Warro! Could he be activated? Oh, only good for the one. Okay, Krasnall's still alive and kicking, though. He could be scary. Those forced out. What a headshot. Oh, my goodness. Okay, some crisp shots, but I don't think we'll see anything else here.
Oh, DemQ, you've got a bit of a chance here, buddy. Gets one with the 5-7. Actually, a fair bit of damage on the AWP player as well, but Krimbo is going to keep things in check. Nice round from Big, and not a terrible T side at all to begin with. The fact that they started off with, at least they kicked off their little streak of rounds with just Tech Nines, I think they're pretty happy about this outcome.
Yeah, they should be. double digits in play here for Big, and of course up against a full eco. They're going to be feeling good. They're going to be feeling confident. They've got money behind them. That last round was quite costly for them. Being on the T side, the guns aren't as expensive, so they don't have to worry too much. But yeah, they lost three players. They had to reinvest, and that does keep them humble at least for now. Nice openings. Faven looking to try and pay off this MAC-10 investment. Someday Young does manage to take him out, but it's only the MAC-10 gone. And I think, to be honest, that's a blessing in disguise for Faven. Means that he'll no-brainer upgrade into an AK in this one, and there's no contingencies in the next. This is an important swing round. The first real proper buy here of the second half. And Big, if they want to keep this up, they want to close out this series, I think winning it would do them some massive favors.
Great little open already from Tito. And I'm not really sure where they're suddenly getting so much wind in their sails, Josh.
Ooh. Yeah, they've just been a different machine, right? This unstoppable force that Monte... Well, it doesn't seem like they know what's hit them. Big kill from SDY, but... As Krasnol follows up with another, I was going to say, I expect them to still sort of fall away for a save here. This is a 5v3. They are having a crack at this. Smoke and a flash is all they have to work with. Look at tabseN's position. He is on such a long flank. I don't even know if he's going to be there in time. Oh, that's sick from Grimbo. Lovely stuff. tabseN, yeah, that was bizarre. I think tabseN was really expecting them to save, which is why he was shifting in the B apartments, thinking they were going to be on the B site, and then he was going to catch them out saving. And then he got there, and he was like, they're not here, guys. They're going for a retake. And then he sort of started to panic and run up short. But yeah, 12-8, big round there for Big, and a four-round lead that could soon be five, as Monty do not have money once again. But at least they've got a loss bonus starting to accumulate, so money to come in the next round, perhaps. Two smokes for here, though, and some pistols and Kevlar. Krasnol with a scout.
Pretty sure the audio issues should be resolved now, and if they're not, I'll just have to fix them before the next map, hopefully. But yeah, this is all you get for now, guys. Sorry. Shouldn't be too difficult of a cleanup for Big. Except, Boros actually is in a pretty good position. The fact that he's behind a smoke shouldn't be too difficult for him to get away with a couple kills. Oh, not a single kill with the Deagle connected. That's rough. Oh. I think you just overthought it a little bit.
Yeah. You sort of see the stars align there, but especially when they found that first kill too. They funnel into the site, and yeah, it's very easy to get overwhelmed in those situations, I guess. Too many targets to choose from, but I thought maybe you'd get a little bit of damage out of that. Not that damage would have too much of a hindrance on the economy here. For Big, I mean, you look at their cash, they're pretty stacked up. They're looking pretty good with it. Krimbo just shy of five figures. tabseN not far off that as well. Hyped, Keto, both around the $7,000 mark. It's only Faven that's lacking behind a little bit, and he's still got enough to act as a bit of a buffer if needs be. So, and of course, there's enough on the team to drop him. They're in a position where they can just sort of continue to buy these ones out. This is a big round. If they take it, they'll be right on the cusp of closing out map one with a very dominant T side. I really wasn't expecting their attack to be as strong as it is here, especially after an 8-7 half, a questionable CT side in certain rounds. They've been absolutely fantastic.
If anything, I really expected Monte to be able to have a much more devastating impact on the server once they would head on over to the CT side, but we're simply not seeing that come out at all. They've won one round, right? And that was the pistol, and right after that, Big's been able to respond.
just 3 rounds away from the finish line on the first map. Monte definitely not feeling too happy about their CT side performance as of now. A little bit of utility to keep those players at bay, and this kind of fake is working out perfectly. All of the attention from the CT side is going towards A. 3 players on the A side, 1 player on short. All the T's have to worry about from apartments is this one player in the form of Krasnol that is waiting with his M4, and now he knows, he's conveyed the information that they're about to move in, and he's gonna fight off all these angles while he's waiting for those reinforcements. Favn finds his head, and the bomb going down should not be a difficult endeavor at all. Now, whether or not the CTs are actually gonna want to go for this.
Yeah, 4v2, you can see they're already calling this one off. Warwick doesn't really have the right tool for the job, that AWP. Definitely don't want to be risking it. Oh no, SDY caught as well. Just trying to save. Waro now doesn't even know where is safe. Holding for an exit, hoping that they don't head toward him. Tabson making far too much noise. But now they know where he is and they know what he's saving. They are going to be hunting him down. They've got enough cash to do so. There's kind of no reason not to. I don't think they're going to get there in time. Favn, again, having to make loads of noise to actually get there in time. Oh, Waro. Lucky. Counting his lucky stars. But 14-8. Another huge round from Big.
I'm a little surprised they're using their tactical timeout now. I would have expected it to come in a little sooner. And they don't really have too much of a lifeline to fall back onto. If they end up heavily investing into this round, next round is pretty much out the window already, and it seems like they want to stop Big at 14. Question is that actually going to work out? Doesn't seem very likely with how under-equipped they are, but at least the utility will be in check.
Well, yeah, it's the round they kind of have to buy into, right? Can't allow Big onto 15, not at a time like this. They got a few more rounds under their belt. They can maybe be confident to pull it back for the OT. But, yeah, with 8 rounds, I think that that's ambitious, to say the least. But a sketchy buy in this one. 2 for masses, an MP9, an M4, an AWP. Not a whole lot of utility. And if they can't get it done, the buy's not going to be much better in the next either. In fact, it'll almost certainly be worse without any saves. Waro lucky that he was able to carry that AWP across from the last so that he could drop a rifle over and still have something substantial here in this one. Minute 20 on this clock already, and look at these just slow default from Big. No one wants to be the one to make a mistake. No one wants to overstep. And as the bomb gets retrieved, it looks like they're going to go for an A split.
I mean, at the very least, the CTs are in really good positions to stop them because they have 3 players already on the site. Early Molotov deployed by Keto, and Boros will start to greet the members who want a red carpet entry into Connector. Big slowly working their way up, but they might be affording a little bit too much time for Monte to get into good positions. Waro trying to catch tabseN around the smoke. Boros down Connector quite nicely. Krimbo does start to move in though, and tabseN now becoming relevant. It's very difficult for the CTs to hold it on. Keto, how do you get away with that? Nice little 180 to put Sum Dae Young in the grave, and all of a sudden, Monte, they're running away with their tails tucked. Crosswell might be able to get away with a nice little kill with the Famas, but let's see. See if they can actually culminate into a 1v2 that ends up working out. Moving out, knows where the AWP is, but hyped with the re-peak, is able to put yet another round for Big. It's been such a landslide, Josh.
Yeah, it really has, especially once they've moved over to this T side. They've just been unstoppable. I don't think we've given enough praise to Keto either. Keto's been unreal. He has been absolutely fantastic. He's 26-14, and he's been the one finding all of these multi-kills, all of these big plays. That was very winnable for Monte when it came into that 3-on-3. It was actually even favorable for them, especially with that crossfire. But Keto just demolishes. And you've got to be feeling pretty rough about it, right, if you're Monte. knowing that he's just firing on all cylinders. There's not a lot they can do to stop him. Nice opening from Faven. Even the MAC-10. This is filthy.
And the fact that he doesn't even have to commit. He can back off, and he's kept so much attention here from the CTs that his site will be up for grabs by the T's. Grimbo gets a kill over to her short, and although DemQ is trying to make this situation a little more palatable, the fact that they're already on A site definitely makes things very hard. Palm down, AWP still on the hands of Hype. Tabson's able to nearly find one, but DemQ still wants to fight back. Hype would have to get away with a massive 1v3 to make it work, but Boros will stop it.
Yeah, unfortunate time in there for Hypes. Knew that no one was going to be facing into him without any kind of double peek or crossfire or flashbang or something. So, yeah, not a lot you can do there. Big round from Monty. Nice little multi-kills there from Boros and DemQ as well. Rounds really, really on their shoulders, to be honest. But still 6 map points here for Big. They've got plenty of money, so the reinvestments will come through. They're on the T-sides. They've got those premium rifles as well. The one-hit headshot potential that comes with the AKs and... some of these players really have been hitting their headshots. Hype sort of stepping up as well. He's not having like a crazy, crazy game by any means or anything like that. But as we say, kind of all eyes are on him right now as this last minute emergency stand-in playing with the roster. And, or maybe not even, emergency replacement, I should say. And he's holding his nerve well. He's having a good game. He's being quite consistent with this AWP. And I'm impressed. I'm excited to see what more is to come.
Definitely a difficult uphill battle for them to fight back against. Slow traversal into short. But Monty, they are going to end up tucking themselves out of that one. That early little boost, since it doesn't yield any dividends, instead they're going to choose to back off. Try and live to see another day. A little bit more passively, but now that the T's are coming up connected, they're going to have to take a little more of a hands-on approach, because one of these players needs to start coming up to the fight. DemQ and Krasnal, a kill apiece. At least the A site's being defended, and Boros will put down Krimbo. Sub Dayoung in the meantime, taking quick advantage of the murder hole, with Hyped being left in a 1v3. This is where Monty are actually starting to turn up the heat a little bit, Josh.
Well, still a long way to go. I'm spotted. Hyped, careful. It's always him in these situations. You gotta be careful with the jump as well. You miss it, you're dead. There we go. Okay, makes a whole load of noise. 20 seconds on this clock. Could have gone and grabbed that bomb, but knows that that's pointless. He's not gonna go and get it on a site. Just wants to hold on to this sniper. And for Monty, I think even though they probably want to get rid of his AWP, they know that Big have got a whole load of money in the bank and their economy is very fragile. So, yeah, holding onto these rifles far more important. And they're in a position where they're on the CT side, they've got 2 AKs. So, yeah, Waro definitely can't justify losing that AWP. And for Sundae Young and DemQ, they don't want to be losing those AKs either. So, 15 to 10, double digits achieved here for Monty. And even if they don't pull this back the full distance, even if they don't take us to overtime, I think these rounds are very valuable just to sort of keep their confidence high. Remember, they've got to go on to a second map after this, and they've actually got to start off on their CT side as well. So had they have just been completely whitewashed and Big had won it 16-8, Monty wouldn't be warned at all. They'd be feeling pretty terrible about their CT defense. We'll see how things go. Still potentially plenty rounds to be played. Skeeto's about to take first contact.
And this is a perfect crossfire. Boros turning up at the right time. Misses a few shots, though, which is why Hyped is able to respond with his AWP. Problem is, Bomb is on a bit of a rock right now, Josh, and trying to retrieve that against three hungry CTs that are coming their way on A, that's not going to be an easy affair at all. I'm not sure if the CTs do want to contest this, though, because DemQ now pops out. Does eventually fall to Krimbo, but at the end of the day, Monty cleans up all those kills, and where we thought that Big was getting away with a landslide potentially, now's not the case anymore. Instead, we could be potentially seeing a close game or even an overtime that Monty can end up winning. Slow start to CT doesn't mean it's going to be a slow finish.
Yeah, definitely not. Wind in their sails now, and finally the economy cracking here for Big. The first sign of weakness in it in quite a while. It's spams through the smoke, not connecting. No one on the receiving end of it. As you say, Monty, no longer a landslide. They are putting up a hell of a fight here on their CT side. And they've had a couple of really good rounds in the last three. Nade does a tickle of damage. Doesn't seem too impactful, but makes Hype now vulnerable to an M4 to the head. And Warwick gets things rolling. Man advantage. Big kill onto Crimbo.
Able to continue to put on the pressure. Monte has really not been letting up after they got their first kill. Sometimes Young, though, over on middle, he's making very quick work of these players here. Hyped is able to get away with some salvation, but I'm not sure how long he's going to be able to last here. But the numbers have evened up. DemQ coming through clutch. Nearly loses life to a Favn that was ready for a 180. But Hype can still make it work. Keep in mind, he's got an AWP, which is the perfect weapon for a one-on-two like this. The only thing standing in between them and him is the fact that he's got 11 points of health.
He's read that situation well, too.
Yeah, they're forced to run into him. It's not like they can save their weapons or anything of that sort. Hype, he's not checking for a ramp, and that's going to be his downfall. First skill collected, and there it is from Warro.
Wow.
Ooh, got very close. If Warro misses that shot, I don't know what to tell you.
That's so huge that that's Warro in that situation as well, right? If it's not an AWP and he's got a rifle, okay, to be fair, he's 11 HP, so I guess it would only mean one bullet's required. But my god, what a hell of a shot for him to hit. And what an important time to actually step up and hit it too. Under that kind of pressure, to keep them afloat in the game wins the 1v1. And I can imagine the adrenaline. I can imagine the team speak sort of erupts a little bit after him hitting a shot like that. You're on the defuse, the well played's come in, and then, okay, clear comms again. We've got to focus. We've got to get our heads back in this because there's still a lot of work to be done. Three rounds in a row required. Fast boost from Monty gives Warro a very early angle here into the apartments, but no one's home. Instead, they're headed on to B. That's not B, on A.
Very important kill for Big Q. It's very late into the race, but they can still pull out now. Chance to get the bomb down comfortably. I don't think we've really seen them in this kind of comfortable position in the past few rounds, with the exception of the 1v1 last round. Bomb starting to tick down. Three sets of kits available. And all that Big have to do is hold their angles. They don't really have the best weaponry in the world for this kind of situation, and the utility is going to be very difficult for them to fight back against. Monty, it's time for them to move in. Lots of damage on Crimbo. DemQ finally puts him down. Favn wants to make himself relevant with the back 10, but he is struggling.
Oh,
every
wow.
single duel goes the way of Monty except one, and they are still in it.
Yeah, you hit the nail on the head at the start of the round. Big hadn't been in a situation like that where they were actually able to get a bomb down and not have a major man deficit in a while, and they still let it slip. But unfortunately for them, because Monty was sort of playing this retake setup, Big weren't able to... remember the last time, right? When we saw the Tech-9s the other way around. We saw the Tech-9s sort of charge in, overwhelm that AWP, and sort of take that CT control, and it gave them guns as well for the post plant. This time around, they get that bomb planted, but once those smokes fade, it's Tech-9s against M4s, and it was not sufficient. Warro creeping around from short, boosting blade towards top or middle, but no one's there. He's not going to flush anyone out with the molly either. He doesn't really want to venture any further forward, not for now.
Big are starting to get a little desperate here. Wouldn't be too surprised if they go for a very basic A execute late into the round. The CTs have pretty much abandoned A, with the exception of DemQ just being available with oppressive utility. And it shouldn't be too long before we see this A hit start to come through. DemQ now knows they're about to push in. Palace player about to make himself relevant as well. Crimbo's gotten so much space here all the way into jungle, and the fact that he gets Boros and DemQ falls as well, suddenly Monty, for it could have been the comeback, it's all falling apart. 2-on-4, they're gonna have to go absolutely huge here.
Oh, that's it. It's surely over. Krasnor and Warro. I mean, Warro's been amazing, but Krasnor knows his impact in this map hasn't been as big, as strong as he would have liked. Now's his time to step up and make up for that loss. Keto in CT. Tabson here. Penultimate headshot. There's the final one. And Big take it 16-13. A fantastic map from them. Could have been a whole lot more one-sided, right? But, I mean, they've closed it out. But as I said before, Monty, that little accumulation of rounds that they took, even though they're going to be disappointed that they couldn't take it to OT, it does give them a little bit of confidence. Remember, there's still one or at least one, possibly two more maps to be played.
It's so weird to think that it started off as a game where we thought Monty would get away with the landslide, but instead,